This video will demonstrate how to use the iterator for the unsorted set. Hello, I'm James Helfrich. The unordered set is the only container in the standard template library that has two iterators, a normal iterator as well as a local iterator. We're going to learn today why that is and how to use both. The unordered set uses a hash table as the underlying data structure. As a reminder, the hash table is an array of lists. You take an element and put it into the hash table by running through a hash function. This hash function converts the element into an index corresponding to which bucket the element is to belong to. The first iterator is called the local iterator. The local iterator will iterate through a single bucket in the hash table. Each bucket corresponds to a list, and so each list has a list iterator. And therefore, the unordered set, its local iterator has a list iterator as its only member variable. So when I say plus plus to the local iterator, I'm actually just plus plussing to the list iterator. The unordered set also has a normal iterator, and this visits every element in the collection. Now this one's quite a bit more complicated, because not only must it iterate within a single bucket, but when it reaches the end of a bucket, it must know how to jump to the next bucket. So therefore, it must have a list iterator for within a single bucket. It must have a vector iterator, which is going to go through the array, and the vector end so it knows it reaches the end of the vector. The most complicated part of this is the advanced function in the iterator. And there are three cases. Case number one is if I'm at the end of the vector, then I just end. I don't want to advance past that point. Case number two, if I'm within a list, but I'm not at the end, then I just advance my list iterator. Case number three, if I've gotten to the end of the list, then I need to find the next bucket. So I need to continue iterating through the vector until I find a bucket that's not empty. And when I do so, then I create my list iterator at the beginning of that element, and then I go from there. To demonstrate this, I'll have a hash function that always returns one. So no matter what value I pass into my hash function, I'll always put things in the one bucket. So we'll start with an unordered set that has six elements and uses hash one, and this will give me six empty buckets. Then I'm going to insert 89. Well, 89 hashed always gives me one, so I'll put it in bucket one. And then 67, which will go after 89, and then 28 after 67, and then 10 after 28. Notice this hash function is really poor. I'm not utilizing five of the buckets. I'm only using bucket one. So when I take a look at the size of each bucket, it's always going to say, it's going to say zero for all buckets, but there's going to be four elements in bucket one. When I show the contents of the entire hash, that's the same thing as showing the contents of bucket one, which will be 89, 67, 28, and 10. And when I show the contents of bucket one, that's also going to be 89, 67, 28, and 10. Let's take a look at a different hash function. This one is going to sum the digits. So I'm going to once again have six buckets, and they're going to be empty, and I'm going to put 89. Now, 8 plus 9 is 17. 17 is going to be my hash value. When I mod it by 6, that's going to give me the bucket number, which will be bucket 5. 67, 6 plus 7 is 13. Mod 6 will give me 1. 28, 2 plus 8 is 10. 10 mod 6 gives me 4. 10 is 1 plus 0 gives me 1. 1 mod 6 gives me 1. So now when I display the size of each bucket, I'm going to get 0, 2, 0, 0, 1, 1. I'm going to show the contents. The iterator is going to start at bucket 0. There's nothing there. Then go to bucket 1, 67, 10. Then once it reaches the end of that bucket, it's going to go to the next bucket, which is empty, the next bucket, which is empty, then give us 28, then the next, and that's empty, then go to the next one, which is 89. So 67, 10, 28, 89. But now if I go use a local iterator for just bucket one, that's only going to give me 67 and 10. The next example, I'm going to use the default hash. Observe how I only pass one template variable to my unordered set. This is instead of integers, where I'm going to have six buckets. But that's the same thing as giving this default hash, which is it can return the value itself. So I start with the constructor, which is going to have six empty buckets. Then I'm going to say 89. So 89 is the hash value. When I 89 mod 6, I'm going to get 5, and that's where I put the value. 67 mod 6 will give me 1. 28 mod 6 will give me 4. and 10 mod 6 will also give me 4. So when I look at the size of each bucket, I'm going to get 0, 1, 0, 0, 2, 1. When I show the contents of the entire hash, once again, I will start at bucket 0. There's nothing there. Then go to bucket 1, 67. Then bucket 2 and 3, which are empty. Then bucket 4, which is 28, and then 10. And then finally bucket 5, which is 89. And when I show the contents of bucket 1, that only has a single value, 67. Let's take a look at the three different hash functions and how they give us different hash tables. Always return 1 underutilizes most of my hash buckets, so I'm only using bucket 1. Sum the digits is a good even distribution, except bucket 1 has a collision. And then finally, when I use my default hash function, bucket 1 only has one element, which is good, but bucket 4 has a collision, so I have different values. You can learn more about how the iterator works for the unordered set by reading the iterator section of the hash chapter of the C++ data structures textbook.